I'm Jim.
And I'm Jim.
And we're the Jims. And we are back, part three of Until Dawn. When we last left our hero, she was standing looking dreamily, much as she is doing right now. I was having a panic attack, hoping that I didn't kill two people by my choices, and he was not talking very much.
Yeah, that's going to be an ongoing theme.
Except it's not, because I'm going to get him to talk at some point. Because it can't just be... It's not...
Jim, come on, be professional.
What?
Your phone, it's, you know, put it on vibrate.
They wouldn't have known anything.
You can probably hear it in our mics.
Well. Maybe. Okay, so I'm a popular guy. People like talk. Okay, it's just the updates of the scores for the sports.
We kind of cut this out, but, you know.
No, we're going to keep this in.
We're going to keep this in so they think
I'm a popular guy. Someone needs to.
Okay, well, put it on vibe right now, at least. Jesus.
What? It did it once.
It did it during the last episode, too. All right. So, I'm playing now. We still haven't had any jump scares or anything happen yet, so...
But I'm pretty sure that's just a matter of time.
Someone there?
Yes.
You can use the right... Okay. Doesn't really move that much, but alright.
Okay, so creepy area is apparently... Creepy. Bravo.
What is that? Was that a crow? Or... I think it was a crow.
That's probably a crow.
It wasn't big enough to be a raven. What does it say? The gate's locked.
No. The gate's busted.
Climb over. Okay, how do I climb? Oh, X, I guess.
R2.
Okay, R2. R. Right.
Okay. Oh, Jesus, never mind.
Chris just wants to see under our skirt.
He just told you that the gate was locked. So how do I... This is just going to do that again? How do I climb it? Or do I have to climb the wall or something?
I'm guessing you have to climb the wall.
Yeah, there's a little blinky thing over here. Okay, there we go.
Safe or quick?
How do I choose? Okay, I just look that way.
Press the button.
Oh, shit.
Press the button!
Oh, no, I pressed the wrong one. I was trying to do it quickly. Even though I picked safe.
Square. There you go.
To climb.
We already have enough blood on our hands. We don't need more.
Oh, that's a creepy noise.
Yes, it is.
No, it sounded like half human, half animal.
I think that's the point.
Is there? Oh.
Hey, little fella. You hungry? Huh?
Don't move.
Cutie.
Aw, it's a squirrel.
Yeah. That's a neat little mechanic there.
That is a I like how they're doing it.
Trying
it's very
to keep the controller still fine.
It's like an... I mean, I've heard of visual novels. This is more like an interactive novel. Is
yeah.
that a term? Can I get credit for that term, or is
I
it
mean,
people use
I
it?
Think there's. It's like a choose-your-own-adventure kind of a thing.
Except in this case, it's choose if you live or die horribly. Oh, what's this? Indigenous people and butterfly prophecies. Okay, read the next part.
Okay. Tribes who once lived in these mountains believed the butterflies carried dreams and prophecies of possible futures. The color of the butterfly indicated the nature of the prophecy. Death is black, red is danger, brown is loss, yellow is guidance, and white is fortune.
So basically, three out of those five butterflies are awful.
Basically.
Oh, great. Look what we found.
What was yellow again? I'm moving. Okay.
And turning it will reveal a colored ball of fire and a premonition of a possible future. Go ahead.
All right,
guidance totem. So press R1.
I don't really know what that was. But
press R1, please.
R1.
I want to see what the totem was. Yellow guidance. Indigenous tribes believe that butterflies brought dreams and premonitions. Each totem piece foretells a possible future event. How you play will determine whether or not these prophecies come true. As you unlock totems, the events of the past will become clear.
Okay.
Well, you didn't even play anything.
Well, I played the same thing that...
Press R1.
That's all it... That's what it played. I pressed play. Yeah, the other one had like a... Oh, I pressed the wrong button. Okay. That's the same clip from before, though.
But this
There's an extra little. Oh, that was creepy. What did it say?
I'm driven mad or something?
And driven mad. Okay.
I'm telling you, it's a therapist. I'm positive. Creepy. And that was creepy as shit.
What does this sign say?
The past is beyond our... Did I call it?
What did you say?
Did I call it? Did I honestly call that it's the therapist?
I'm gonna just do something real fast. Nope, there we go.
You want subtitles on?
Yeah.
Okay. We could have done that at the start. In case you can't read, it says, the past is beyond our control, in blood.
Wait, that made you think it was the therapist? Is that because he said that?
Chris?
Is that what?
Yes.
Okay. I didn't remember. Yeah, he did say that. What is this over here?
It's backpack.
Backpack.
Bag's here. Where are you? Not in the bag, are you?
How the fuck would he manage that?
I'm pretty sure it was a joke. Hopefully he's not dead.
Ooh, what are you gonna do?
I'm totally gonna friggin' snoop.
Of course you're gonna snoop.
I mean, he's missing.
We have changed the narrative of the game.
It's not like snooping if the guy's missing.
Chris.
I'm investigating where the hell you went off to.
Chris has a crush on Ashley. Methodical, protective, and humorous. And he has a crush on Ashley. Stop laughing.
Oh, Jesus. I don't want to point. Okay.
Are you my second?
I was buzzing.
Butterfly effect update.
Thanks for letting me know. I can take it from here. Oh, so I found something kind of amazing.
What?
I'm not going to tell you. You got to see for yourself. Come on. It's this way.
Where? This never ends well.
Right around here.
Yeah.
Blow your mind.
It's gonna blow my mind.
Status update? What are these things meaning?
Is it somebody who's gonna actually blow my mind out of my brain?
Uh-oh. Press R1. Press R1 now. Clue found wanted poster. Wanted poster found lower cable car station. A torn up wanted poster about a fugitive on the mountain dated 1998. Someone didn't want people to see this. Wanted.
Victor Milgram.
Good.
Victor Milgram, less known location, Blackwood Pines, last seen 1998. Wanted connection, first degree arson. Anyone with information? Okay. So, this is set in like modern day though, right? So that was like quite a while ago. Mm-hmm.
Collect clues to solve the mysteries until dawn and increase your chances of survival. Oh, so we need to find clues so we hopefully survive.
Pretty rad, right? Milgram would be a pretty fit name for the therapist, dude.
Milgram. Stanley Milgram.
Yeah.
You think that might be the same person?
Why is this even here?
I don't know. I don't think Stanley Milgram was like a psychopath. He proved that anyone could be a psychopath, but I don't think he was one himself.
All right, here goes.
Well, Jim, you like guns.
Okay.
Have fun with this one.
Am I supposed to shoot the cans or the bags?
Supposed to shoot something.
How do I shoot? R2 to shoot. So I pressed R2.
Give me the damn thing if you're not gonna shoot.
I'm pressing R2. Nothing's happening.
I don't think your target.
Let me see this.
Oh. Alright. Okay, I pressed R1. That brought that up. I don't know. Wait, this is. Am I supposed to. Oh, she was supposed
there
to
you
shoot
go.
Them in order. Okay, well, that's stupid.
Now you got it, that one. Alright, you're a marksman. The timer ring shows how much time we have left.
Wow, nice shooting, Tex.
Alright, I'm bad. I'm a badass.
I'm gonna go ahead and guess it's a wild case of beginner's.
You're the biggest dork, and that's me saying that.
Yeah, people who are badasses usually don't dance around and proclaim it.
Well, anybody and their brother can shoot a bottle that big, that close.
Oh my. Don't you dare shoot that squirrel.
Are we going to have to shoot the squirrel? I don't want to shoot the squirrel.
Shoot the bag.
I'm not going to shoot the squirrel. I like squirrels.
Your ass just got sacked.
Oh, this guy's annoying.
Don't make me shoot the squirrel.
Wait, I'm just getting
okay. Okay, so what that basically means is that because we didn't shoot the squirrel, good things are happening. I'm thinking a good thing.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah, that's probably what's...
Because we're changing the narrative, because I'm guessing she would have been pissed because she just fed the squirrel.
It's definitely weird coming back up here after a whole year.
Yeah, I swear, the moment I got here, it all came flooding back.
Here goes fast.
And it didn't come flooding back to him at all, because he was... No, wait, no, I don't know.
He's the murderer.
Was he passed out drunk? He wasn't passed out drunk.
He might have been passed out drunk. I don't remember.
There were two guys, I think, who were passed out drunk.
Or is he one of the people, responsible for this?
The door's locked.
Yeah. Josh wanted us to keep
it. You already knew it was locked.
He said that? What people?
I don't know. He said they found people sleeping in the station one time.
It's getting creepy again.
I thought they said something about their ride being here.
I think this is the station for the cable car.
Oh, it's the cable car stuff. Okay, right.
It must be really hard on Josh.
I don't know how he keeps it all together. I'd be a wreck.
Well, we're all just going to have to keep an eye on him. He must be going through so much, and he seems like the kind of guy who's not going to just ask for help.
So, this is like their own private cable car station?
Yeah.
It's
a crazy place to set up house.
Blackwood Pines Hotel and Sanatorium. For a healthy body and mind.
Hotel and Sanatorium. They had residents who were not patients? I would not stay at a hotel that was also a sanatorium.
Check the locker. Is there anything there?
I didn't see an X or anything. I didn't see anything else lighting up.
You're pretty bold. The sleeping giant of Blackwood Forest.
Oh, shut up. Finally. You coming?
Yeah, well, I was going to stay here and catch some Z's, but...
Stay for a second. Don't get on. What? The reason I'm saying don't get on is because I'm looking and I think we're going to have to cut this video right here, right before we get on.
That's a good idea. Yeah.
So, again, the game gets a lot creepier. It's got a great atmosphere. I don't know what to think regarding this guy, this setting. Apparently we're making good choices now because we saw the white butterfly. And the white butterfly means, guidance.
I didn't even know the white butterfly. But white wasn't guidance. Yellow was guidance.
Yellow's guidance.
White was like good or something.
Yeah, white is like, we're making right decisions. And that's probably because I haven't touched the controller. I will touch the controller.
Well, you wouldn't have shot the squirrel either.
I would not have shot the squirrel. No. Especially after she just found it. But he gets the easy choices. I'm going to get the hard choices and kill people. And I'm sure that's what you really want to see. You want to see my mental state break and him laugh at me.
Yeah, well, that's what I want to see. I'm pretty sure they'd be happy with either of us, you know, getting scared.
Well, that is probably going to happen. It's got a very creepy atmosphere. I know the game's going to get scarier, but right now it's just all atmosphere and unsettling, and I'm kind of digging it. So
yeah, I'm digging it too.
So we will see you in the next installment of Until Dawn. It's going to be part 4. We wish we could make these longer, but we're keeping them short. As I said, this is the start of the Let's Play channel. We hope that, you know, you tell everyone. We should have done this in the last 3 videos too, but if you enjoy what you're watching, you want to see more, please don't forget to press the subscribe button.
Like, favorite, and subscribe. And I'm Jim.
And I'm Jim, and we are still
the Gems. See you next time.